What's up, Epic Brawl Stars gamers? Welcome back to a brand new video. Inside today's video, I am playing with GuilleVGX again and also TwistiTwik. We are playing 3v3 at above 1000 trophies. As you can see right now, my card is at 1064 trophies. We'll be taking a look at some of the games that got me there. So let's take a look at these games. Okay, so the combo we're using is Daryl, Piper, and Carl. I'm playing Carl. And let's follow me here. Okay, so we're playing on Snake Cavern. And this map, there's a lot of walls, so like the first fault would probably be Piper is not that great, and it's more like a maps for tank. But Piper is actually really good because in the late game she can break the walls, and you can see already like Twisty got his first super and he's able to break all the walls down pretty much. So even though the like she's able to pick up the first gems, I'm able to get her. It would not have mattered if I didn't get her, because as long as there's not 10 gems on the map, like, it's not really gonna matter. It's just the team that's gonna end up with the last 10 gems that's really gonna matter. If you can get a kill, for example, it's gonna change everything. So now that the Mortis is sitting on the gems, you can't go that aggressive here in the early game. So it really, really doesn't matter at all here to start out with. And Twisty is just getting super back again, so he can destroy the walls even more. I'm going on the side against Penn. You definitely don't wanna clump up in the middle. And yeah, Daryl, he's pretty good as well. He's like an aggressive brawler, whereas with Piper and Carl, it's more going back, being defensive. And yeah, I would say if you don't have these brawls, like instead of Daryl, you can use the other tanks. They're also good, but I mean, you probably already have these brawls, so that's also why it's a pretty good combo for you guys to go in with. And yeah, it is very high level gameplay. At above 1000 trophies, I already said this. So it's of course some very good teams we're going up against, so it might be a little bit different at lower trophy ranges, but this should definitely be a good combo to go with. And here you can see I'm just walking in front of TwistiTwik. There's only 5 seconds left. He's alone, and yeah, he's gonna try to pull, but there's no time. So that's gonna be a win for us for the first game. So yeah, you can see that Gene almost at 1000 trophies, but that's a GG right there. Let's take a look at the other game. Okay, so here for the next match, we're going up against a different combo. And here we're going up against Barley, 8-bit, and a Carl. So a pretty similar combo, but they do have this thrower. Throwers are pretty popular on this map. But yeah, of course, it's really strong here to start out with. But like Twisty already got a super, he's going to be able to go up and break open that wall really nice here. And also just me on the right side, I can shoot in the middle because now they have to go together. Of course, here I put myself in a little bit bad spot because I didn't go out fast enough, and the other car was able to get a super first. But Gi able to finish up. Twisty sitting in all the gems here, so even though we don't have control right now, like we already have most of the gems, and we are gonna respawn in just a little bit time. So what I would say is definitely, it's not worth it to go in and get the kills and gem grab if you already have the control, because they're gonna respawn, and it really doesn't take that long for them to respawn, come back up with full HP. So if they are low, you can just stay back, heal up as well, so you're ready for them to push up again. And in the meantime, your gem carrier is gonna be able to like get the gems in the middle, or you're gonna be able to push the mid and help him so he can regain the control. So here, really nice, like going in, almost getting the gems, but of course the 8-bit gonna respawn. So now we just need to get a kill on the 8-bit. The 8-bit is pretty slow, his teammates, they died. He doesn't have the respawn anymore. So like we're going in here, all of us, and the barley on the gems is not really gonna help anything. We're gonna be able to get the 2 kills, like clean up the team, get all the gems here, and when you have the gems in champ grab, it's just gonna be so hard to come back. So when they're just charging up towards us, we can just shoot them on our retreat back, and even if we die, we are in our spawn, so we should be able to respawn on top of the gems. So of course you want to just make sure you have enough gems so they can't pick up gems to cancel out your countdown. But yeah, right here it was no problem for us. GG. And you can see how strong Piper she really is, because even if someone go in for her, she can just jump away. But let's take a look at the other game. Okay, so here we're going up against another really strong combo with Poco, with Rosa, and with Tick. So again, a thrower. This time, Tick might even be better here for gem grab than Barley, just because the explosion got a buff in the last like update. But Gear definitely like getting a really good beginning here, taking out both the Rosa And the Poco, he just have to watch out, because now that they're gonna have super, it's gonna be more tough for him. But of course, also Twisty's gonna get his super and gonna be able to break open the wall. And the fun thing about Daryl is just he can super in all the time. Like with Carl, he's more like the defensive brawler, so you just want to make sure that you are like controlling your side and helping Twisty when he needs help. For example, this Rosa here pushing up towards me, and I have my super here, so I'm just gonna go for the middle with my roll. That's also like some elements of being defensive, but also some elements of being able to get going that aggressive sometime when you have your super. But now we only need like two more gems. That Rosa not really able to get that much value out of the super, and Twisty of course able to just jump away, and they don't really have that like brawl on that team that can really go for Twisty, so he should be fine in this matchup. Like he outranges everybody, so he's just chilling in the middle. He also got his jump away, so that's gonna be a GG here against this team. So definitely like a good combo they have, but I think our combo is much stronger there. So that's gonna be another win, but there's still more games, so let's take a look at it. Okay, so here for this matchup, they have Double Thrower and they have Mortis as a mid. So this is a very like off-meta combo, not something you see very often. Like in the beginning, like you can see how strong it is. We can't really get close to them. Me and Twisty are just being pushed away. Also Gear can't really do much. So Mortis going in. Also charging up a super. So we really need Twisty to get a super. He's the only brawler on the combo that can break open walls, so that might be a little bit of a weakness. If they can do a really, really good job at staying alive and not feeling super, then I think they could probably win. But Double Thrower is just not that strong. So here we're able to come from both sides, because me and Twisty push behind them. So now that me and Gear have regained control, like Twisty should also be pretty close to his super. And having that Mortis on the gems, like in the beginning the Mortis could go aggressive. Now that he have 5 gems, he can't really go aggressive in the same way, because if he dies now, that means we will get enough gems to get countdown. And that's why Mortis is just not that strong for like gem carrier. And now Twisty got a super as well, so he's gonna be able to break some walls or just get away from the Mortis if he have to. But like if you look at the gems, it is like they actually have the small lead, but as I said, it's just not gonna be that easy for them in the late game when we break open more of the walls. And once we get a super as well, you can see here I have my super. I go in, I'm not gonna be able to kill him, but I am gonna get him over to Twisty, so Twisty's gonna be able to get him. And like the Mortis going in, he got 9 gems now just by going in and grabbing them and getting out again. But now that Twisty have opened up so much of the map, like it's gonna be impossible with the Double Thrower combo, with Mortis as well. Like it's like we have 7 as well, so even if they get it, we can just come back. So like the Mortis have been doing a really good job at staying alive, but he just cannot go aggressive and help his teammates. Like if he can get Twisty here, you can see then he could have probably gotten the win, but Twisty is able to get a super so quick. With Piper, you can just outtime him if they're close enough, so Piper is really strong here in this meta. Here you can see it as well. Even though this map is, I would say, really strong for Throwers and Mortis, etc., we're still able to win here with this combo, just because like Piper is so strong and we can break the walls and just change the map. So it basically doesn't even matter what map it is, you can make this combo work, because you can just break the walls as it fits you. But you can see Twisty also getting stopped later, really nice. But yeah, let's take a look at the last game. Let's go. Okay, so here jumping into the last game, they are playing with BB, Mortis and Crow. So don't think you see Crow that often, but I think that's because on this map you see so much tanks, because tanks are so great. It is a great tank counter, and that's like on this map you see a lot of tanks, so when you start seeing some tank counters, then we have like a counter to the counter combo. So it's like next level here, okay? So after the beginning, Piper going down, but now that we're starting to charge super, Daryl can get a super really quickly, so that's really nice. Even though they got some of the first gems, you can see what I'm talking about. All of them going down, we're able to pick up all the gems that they got, so it doesn't matter. If they can manage to stay alive with the gems, then it's not gonna help them that they got them to start out with. So Twisty went down again, I went down, he able to finish again there. So 7 gems here, off to the beginning. With Gear as gem carrier, So it's a little bit weird now. He can't really go aggressive. So he's like the new gem carrier, and sometimes these situation happens, but you just have to get change to them. Because of course it wouldn't make sense if Twisty he went in and picked up a gem as well, because then they could kill either Twisty or Gear. So here they have to just kill Gear. It's a little bit BM, but yeah, the BB actually almost getting Gear, but that's gonna be game right there. So playing together with GuilleVGX and TwistiTwik, getting all the wins, pushing above 1,000 trophies here. So we might push to rank 35 together, all of us, but Twisty and Gear, they're doing those crazy pushes. It will be so interesting to follow, but definitely GG's, and I hope you enjoyed the video with this top tier gameplay. Leave a like on it if you'd like to see more, then I'll try to see if I can find maybe some other top players to play with as well. Let me know down in the comments who you'd like to see me play with, but that's it for the video. I hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you in one of the next videos. Bye!